Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Today, what I wanted to talk to you all about is how to set up a RAM disk in your Linux system. There's a variety of reasons you might use one. I like the idea of using it to store temporary files, like cache files, for serving out real-time media streams. Not real-time media as in, like, real-time media, like, from the 90s, but I mean real-time media in the sense, like, live streaming video, like Apple HLS or MPEG Dash temporary stream traffic. Stuff like that that's going to be files that would be served over a web server temporarily. Anyway, regardless of what your use case is, let's hop right on into showing you how to do it. So in my case, I actually have a script that does it for me. And that script comes really in handy. So I've just got a couple lines here. It creates the folder. So we have to do that first of where we're going to place the mount point. Then we're going to set that folder, in my case, to 777, meaning full permissions to everybody on the entire system. It's only me, but it just makes it simple. And then I use this mount command with the file system type of tempfs to create the RAM system, to create the RAM drive. And then I select the option size and this $1. What that means is that whatever I put in as the first argument is going to be placed there. And then I put in the size I want so I can dynamically change it. Then we have the name of the drive. I call it video. And then we have the location again. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and try and create it. So I've got the command here, create dash media dash RAM disk space 4G. So this 4G is, like I said, going to be that argument. I hit enter. I'd already asked for my password because I did it once before and I had an error, so I had to do it again. But after a few minutes, it would ask me for the password again, but you just go ahead and enter it and then you're done. And now if we actually look at the df dash dash h command, so this is the disk free command of human readable options, we have a drive called video. 4 gigs is here and none of it's in use. And so now I'm going to go ahead and actually create something in there to show you that we can actually fill up this. So I'm just going to go and we're going to reload this. And just like that, we have some data in use. How easy was that, everybody? Well, I hope you thought it was pretty easy. And let me know if you have any questions about this in the comments. Thanks for watching Open Source Tonight, everybody. See y'all again very soon. Goodbye, everybody. And action.